The learning objectives of this chapter are that the learner will know the various onboard fuel requirements and be able to identify the various machinery fuel requirements. In order to be able to operate effectively, ships need to be self-contained as far as power and services are concerned. They require propulsion power to move from place to place. They also need to generate electrical power to run the various systems on board, such as lighting, water systems, hydraulic systems, and so on. In some cases, they also need to generate steam power, either for propulsion purposes or for driving other machinery or for a source of heating. To provide this power will normally require the combustion of fuel. Combustion can be thought of as the process of converting the chemical energy of the fuel into heat energy. The heat energy is used to drive a heat engine, which produces the power to do the required work. This can be either directly, for example the diesel engine, or indirectly, for example a steam turbine, where the combustion of fuel is used to generate steam, which then drives the turbine. Internal combustion engine is the term used to describe a machine which burns fuel directly in the engine cylinder. Other engines, such as a steam turbine, are sometimes referred to as external combustion engines. The various pieces of ship's equipment that require fuel directly to operate are shown in the list. There are many different duties that this equipment may be used for. Diesel engines may be used for propulsion power, electrical power generation, and also direct drive of some pieces of equipment, for example, emergency air compressor or fire pump. Boilers may be used to produce steam, to provide propulsion power or electrical power generation, or a source of heating for various systems. Gas turbines, although not common, may be used for propulsion and electrical power generation. Incinerators may require fuel for first start or for mixing with the waste material, such as oil sludge, in order to ensure steady combustion. Oil-fired thermal oil units and inert gas generators are usually found on board vessels which do not have steam boilers. They are used to provide general heating services and inert gas for the cargo tanks, respectively. The fuel system for each is similar to that of a low-pressure steam boiler. Fuel systems are required to correctly supply the fuel to all of this equipment in a way that ensures good combustion. When fuel is delivered to the ship, it will initially be put into storage tanks. The fuel is then transferred to the settling tanks for cleaning and pre-treatment before it is delivered to the service tanks for use in the various in-service fuel systems. These storage and pre-treatment requirements are covered in detail in Seagull CBT Module Number 10. For steamships operating with conventional boilers and steam turbines, the fuel may be taken directly from the storage or settling tanks to the boiler fuel system with minimal cleaning or preparation. We will not consider the storage handling and pre-treatment systems in this module. In this module, we will look at some typical fuel systems for marine diesel engines, and also look at the basic requirements for a marine boiler fuel oil system. We will start from the service tank, and look in detail at the fuel systems and the individual components that are required in these systems for the various diesel engines and the boilers. Before moving on to these systems, we need to look at the different fuel types that will be used, and also consider some basic combustion theory. It is necessary to have some knowledge of combustion in order to understand why the various components are included in the systems. In this introductory chapter, we have seen that there is a need for a number of different fuel systems for the machinery that you will find on board the ship. Obviously, we can only consider typical systems, and you should always refer to the drawings and documentation on board to get specific details about the actual plant fitted. In the next chapter, we will have a brief look at the different fuel types that you will have to deal with.